Completion in 10 seconds. Android scan complete. Detonation in 10 seconds.
So I'm gonna walk you guys through it. So first, what you need to do is you need to have a surface scanner, detailed surface scanner. Next, you're gonna need prospector limpet. Doesn't have to be the greatest prospector limpet, but you want to have a pretty decent collector limpet, because your collector limpet, like the better it is, the more collectors you can have out. But mine's not that great. I can only have two, but it works well for voidable mining. So you're also gonna need a seismic charge launcher. It can be problematic if you just have one, because as you can see there, I only have 63 spare ammo, and it takes about five or six to crack one open if there's not very many high spots. Like they'll have different variants: low, medium, and high. Based on the low, medium, or high, you're gonna have to either charge it just once, twice, or three times. In the middle of my screen, you should see like little lines. Those will fill up. So the first bar on the right of my cursor is at the very bottom, that's like low, and then the middle ones are medium, and then the top ones are high. So you just charge it up based on like what pull it is, you know. And then there's the deep subsurface displacement missile. Basically, once you sometimes there'll be like a surface deposit that you'll have to destroy, or sometimes it's below the surface. The subsurface, blaster is for like the top parts, and then the missile is for like, it's like a drill, basically. You're gonna have to charge that one up as well. But it's a different like little mini game, I would call it. Anyways, also you're gonna need a pulse wave analyzer. What that does is it allows me to see like, it's kind of hard to see that, but once I pull out of here, you'll be able to see it a lot better. I just gotta make sure. Also, when you're in an ice field, it's best to have night vision on, so that you can make sure that you're not gonna accidentally run into something. Okay, now, I usually pull above the rings, and I'll just, I'll just be going forward, and you see how the certain ones light up? You're looking for the brightest ones. So it looks like there's one hiding over there. Do you see it? I don't know. It's not very bright. But as you could tell earlier, that one was super duper bright. That one's kind of bright. Let's go there. I don't know if it's gonna, this one's kind of red. You see that? You're looking for like a bright yellow one. This one probably has a core, but it's probably not voidables. But still, these can be good too, because sometimes based on like what fields you're in, you might be able to get diamonds out of these, or some sort of high commodity. So all of them are really okay, if they're really bright, Like, there's a couple bright ones here, but they're kind of misleading. I'm specifically going for void opals. They also have a certain shape. I like ice fields because, they're the easiest to tell. Like, this one's probably another void opal. This one right here. Yeah, that's definitely a void opal one. see how bright that is no matter how close I get. Except when I'm like right on top of it. Now if I back up a little bit, super duper bright, look at that. So let's get out of our prospector. We're gonna shoot that one out there. You don't have to aim specifically. Also, remember to target your prospector, because that's how you'll tell what's inside of it. See, this one actually didn't have a core. It's misleading, but let's see what these, you know, surface deposits, not what I'm looking for. Still, you know. Oh, that's not what I meant to do. So, that one's not a very good one. Sometimes I get misled, you know. They have to be super duper bright. See, I'm not even gonna go for that one. Even though it looks promising, it's not. You'll know when you see it. Also, if you have head look enabled, you can do like kind of like a, you know, you can kind of look directions. You don't even have to, you know, really, really look. This asteroid belt isn't very large. Because it's mostly red, you know, and based on what I've been pulling out of these asteroids so far, I'm guessing that that's more of that Hydron, whatever the hell, you know, you've seen it earlier, it's what was in the other one. This one's promising. Yeah. Probably not what I'm looking for. It is spinning pretty crazy. Oop, I got close, didn't I? So I'm gonna turn here. Usually there's people, like, it's best to start, like, even if there's a hot spot of where resources are, it's best to, like, start at the edge, like at the very, very edge of the lit up area, and then just kind of work your way through it. Mm-hmm. like I was saying earlier, they have a certain shape to them. Like, they almost look like walnuts. This. See the comparison? That one's more darker red, this one's yellow. Yeah. In ice rings, that's what I'm in right now. In ice rings, this is what you're looking for. It does vary based on the type of ring. It's harder to find them in other rings. Well, let's see how... see, it's got a high pool of content, but it's not big enough, apparently. That one's awfully misleading. Let's see what's in this one. Mineral content low.
Asteroid scan complete.
Methane. See, that's not bad. Methane isn't bad. But again, not what we're looking for. This is a good example of why you need, you know, lots of inputs. Collector bids and otherwise. Ooh, look at that cheese ball. This one got kind of dark. But it's still got multiple colors. Crystals. See that? That's the special thing it has in it, is crystals. 12%. Still not worth breaking both of them. Also, you don't have to, you know, do, you know, just... You don't have to mine things for specific resources. You could just... equip some mining lasers, come out here to one of these asteroids and just make sure. Ignore that. Hope this isn't one of those special ones. And it's not. So, we're gonna poke some holes in this big bad boy. I know it. Yeah, I'm just gonna pop out some random stuff. Go get him, collector.
Cargo scope deployed.
And these types of minerals are usually minerals that you can use for, like, crafting ammo, you know, like, stuff that isn't for, like, you know, special things. Like, it's not for selling or for trading, it's, like, for your crafting. Which is very handy when you're doing, like, deep space exploration. It's like some of these bad boys can actually fill up your ship. I got a vessel approaching on my six. I might have to get out of here early. Uh-oh. My refinery's full.
Your pit drone error. Deploy cargo hatch. Cargo scoop retracted.
This is the first time I ran into that issue where, you know, I couldn't refine whatever it was that I picked up. Interesting. All that means is that I need, you know, certain materials to refine other materials, which is, you know, it's like the combining method of, you know, that game that everybody says that this game is like, where you control your fleet. No Man's Sky, you know, there's combinations of things that you can bind together, and I'm sure that's one of those that are in this game. Damn, a lot of these are really misleading. Yo, what's good? Yeah, I can see that. I am Void Opal mining in Elite Dangerous. I'm flying through an asteroid field, blowing up asteroids with seismic charge launchers. Elite Dangerous. Yeah. Great game. Great game. Yeah, I actually invited you to a stream the other night, but yeah, figured. Ooh, I might be coming up on another. No, you said that I'm gonna run to the store real quick, and I said okay. When you get back, I'm gonna have a stream of Elite Dangerous going. Like, and passed out. Yeah. That's cool. No. No. A brute Tigrex. I have been putting off Void Opal mining for some time, sir. And I need to get it done because they're fixing to change the whole trading and commodity market thing. Like, they're gonna reduce Void Opals for sure because there's people that spend about, 6 hours out here and come back with millions. Like, sometimes a couple billion. And that, I don't know if you've ever played Elite Dangerous, but if you went through the grind of your first million in this game, you would understand that that's like insane. Depends on your preference. Like, the graphics in this game are flipping insane, dude. Like, if you like space exploration, this game is dope. No, this is nothing. Like, the only thing that compares from No Man's Sky to this is that you're in a ship and you're traveling through space. That's it. Like, the combat in this game, so much more better. Like, to put it in perspective for you, this game isn't just a game. It's a spaceship flight simulator. Anyways, I just wanted to pop in, say what's up. This is gonna take a couple hours, bro. I don't know if you're gonna be up. Each asteroid yields about 11 after you break it open. It takes about 3 to 5 minutes to break each one open after finding them, right? And you can carry, after you have an upgraded ship and all that, you can carry up to like probably 260 to 300 things at a time. So. You don't have to. I mean, like, one voidable sells for about 1.5 mil to the right buyer. So once I'm full, that's it. Leave it. It just takes some time to get full. Well, you guys enjoy. Alright, cool. this route. Of course, I'll check little dots and see if I have been there before. No, that's terrible.
Friendship drive charging.
Sector scan complete. Surface scan complete. Surface scan complete.
Thank you.
Detonation sequence initiated. Detonation in 10 seconds.
Be right back. So,
thank you. Initiation sequence initiated.
detonation in 10 seconds.
Chicos tacos.
location in 10 seconds. Limpet expired.
Engaged. Thank you.
engaged.
Didn't even void open mine with me though.
Cockpit engaged. Asteroid scan complete. Detonation in 10 seconds.
Thank you.
Hello?
Hey, I need you to bring me my charger.
Your charger? Over to Jeremy's? Damn it. It's cold outside, you realize this, yes? Okay. That's the end of this stream.